Today we're talking about the biggest speedrun mistake that you should avoid in After Effects. Firstly, I'm going to show you the mistake itself, and then I'm going to show you the proper way of doing speedruns in After Effects. So let's jump in and get started. So we're going to work with this clip here, and I'm moving back and forward from the car's wheel, as you can see, and the clip is too long. It's 38 seconds. And the biggest mistake that I see a lot of tutorials teach you to do is just right click on the clip and go to the time, enable time remapping, and then just drag this last keyframe closer to the first one, and voila, your speed ramp is ready. But there is a big mistake here, because we sped up the entire clip and we don't get a chance to choose the beginning and the end of our speed ramp. Now that we learned how not to do speedruns, let's learn how to do them properly. So let's assume that you have a music and you want to sync your speedruns to the beats. So what you're gonna do is select your music and double L on your keyboard, and you just need to listen to the music and add your markers via this button right here. So let's assume that my beat is somewhere right here. I'm going to add marker. Next one is somewhere around here. I'm going to add the marker, and this will allow us to choose the beginning and the end of our speed ramp. So what you need to do is select your clip and go to the time and enable time remapping, and select this first key right here and just move this time like so. And by doing this, we're just selecting the beginning of our speed ramp, and let's move to the marker itself. And again, just drag this time to somewhere right here. So we selected the end of our speed ramp, and rest of the clip, we don't need it. Just press Ctrl, Shift and D, and just press backspace. Voila, it's deleted. We have this portion right here, and we can also go and delete this last keyframe because we don't need it honestly there. So what we need to do next is we need to select those keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. And with those keyframes selected, we need to go to the graph editor, right click and select edit value graph. And if your graph looking like this, you should click on this button right here. So we need to select this first one and do thing like this. Select the last one and do something like this. So basically what this will do, it will speed up your clip, then it will play normal and then speed out again. And this is basically it for this graph editor. Let's go back and view what we created. It will speed up and then we'll go slow and then speed up again. So if you're happy with the results, you can leave it as is, but you can spice up it a bit more, go to the effects, and if you have RSMB plugin, you can just throw it and it will create a motion blur, or you can use the fast motion blur, but the RSMB plugin is better. So if you want to get greater results, you should use this plugin right here, and it will create this smooth motion blur. And basically this is how to do it properly.